Hello, my dear children. Welcome to Learner's Planet. Children, in the previous session, we discussed about work, energy, the different forms of energy, friction, and force. And in today's session, we will continue this lesson and we will learn about simple machines. So children, as you know that in everyday life, we use various tools to make our work easier. For example, a gardener uses a wheelbarrow to carry dried leaves. Even we use a pair of tongs while cooking. We use a pair of scissors to cut paper. So basically, we use tools which make our work easier. So how can we define a simple machine? Let us start with this session and learn about simple machines. Yes, a tool that makes our work easier by helping us overcome a large force called as load by applying lesser force known as a foot is called a machine, right? So we can say that a larger force is known as load and lesser force is known as a foot. Means a foot is made by us and load is acting on an object. So a tool that makes our work easier by helping us overcome load by applying effort is called a machine. So machines may be simple or they may be complex. Like a simple machine uses a single applied force to overcome a single force. For example, there are many types of simple machines. Like this is a screw. This is a wedge, right? This is a bar. Here we apply force. That means this is effort. And this is the load, right? And this is the fulcrum, right? So all these things include to form a lever. So this is, lever is also a type of simple machine in which a single applied force is used to overcome a single force. Even an inclined plane. This is also a type of simple machine, right? So we can say that a simple machine uses a single applied force to overcome a single force. And a complex machine consists of two or more simple machines working together. Like a pair of scissors. What can you observe here? How we can consider this as a complex machine? We can consider it because it consists of two or more simple machines. Like we can say that this portion of a scissor acts as a wedge and this portion acts as a lever. So lever is a simple machine, wedge is also a simple machine, right? So we can say that a pair of scissors is a complex machine because it consists of lever and wedge. So there are two simple machines which are working together and that is why we consider a pair of scissors as a complex machine. Even a bicycle consists of wheel and axle and it also consists of a lever. And that is why it is considered as a complex machine. Even this wheelbarrow is considered as a complex machine because it consists of wheel and axle and also lever. Even the nail cutter is an example of a complex machine, right? Because it consists of screw and lever, right? So these are the complex machines. So we can say that a machine is a tool that makes our work easier by helping us overcome a larger force by applying lesser force. So they can be simple or they can be complex. So here we will only discuss simple machines which are of the following six types. So let us see that which six types of simple machines exist over here. Yes, they are lever, pulley, inclined plate, wheel and axle, wedge and screw. These are the six types of simple machines which we are going to discuss. Right? So in this session, we will discuss about liver. Only liver. Right? So first of all, we should know that what is meant by a lever. Yes, a lever is a rigid rod. Here you can see a rigid rod or a bar. It is a rigid rod arranged in such a manner that it can move freely around a fixed point. Means this is the fixed point and it can move up and down. Right? So it consists of three parts. Which three parts? Yes. The first one is, this is acting as a load. Here we are putting an effort. And this is the fulcrum. So it includes load, fulcrum and effort. And for a lever to work or to move freely around a fixed point, it need to have a rigid rod or a rigid bar. And that makes up a simple machine. So we can say that a lever is a simple machine that makes it easier to lift, move or pry the things apart. A lever needs four things to do work: a bar, a fulcrum, a load and an effort. So what is meant by these three terms? Yes. What is meant by fulcrum, children? Yes, this is the fixed point around which the rod moves. As we saw in the picture, this is fulcrum. So what we can say that this is the fixed point around which the rod moves. Then, load is the object on which work is to be performed. And effort is the force that needs to be applied on the rod in order to perform a task. Right? So we can say that fulcrum, load and effort are the three parts with which a lever like simple machine is formed. So based on the position of these three parts, they are divided or classified into three types. Right? So the components of a lever can be arranged in three different ways to give three different kinds of liver. So based on the position of these three parts, that is fulcrum, load and effort, it can be classified into following three types. That is first class liver, second class liver and third class liver. So now let us discuss about each of them in detail. So the first one is the first class liver. So children, livers in which the fulcrum is located between the load and the effort are called first class or class 1 livers. So here you can see that fulcrum is located in between the load and the effort. And that is why it is considered to be the first class or class 1 livers. Now this can be better explained with the help of example. For example, a scissor. You can see here that in between this is the fulcrum. Means this is the fixed point around which the scissor can move. If this is not there, then there will be no use of scissor. Scissor will not be able to move. We will not be able to cut anything. Right? So this acts as an effort. And this acts as a load. Means, effort means we are applying force at this end. That means we are applying force on this in order to perform a task, in order to cut a paper or in order to cut the hair. Right? So, you might have observed in the barber's shop that a barber always cuts the hair with the help of scissor. He is able to cut the hair because of scissor, with the help of scissor. Right? So scissor always acts as a first class lever because it has the fulcrum placed between the load and the effort. Now let us see other examples. Yes, This is a seesaw. In seesaw also, the fixed point is in between on which this rod moves. So the fixed point here acts as a fulcrum. So where is the fulcrum? It is in the between. It is placed between the effort and the load, right? So here the boy is making an effort and the load is this girl. Even it can be vice versa. But fulcrum will be placed in between. Here when the girl comes down, when the seesaw moves, then the girl acts as an effort and boy acts as a load. So be less concerned that what acts as a load or what acts as an effort. If the fulcrum is placed in between, that means it is the first class lever. In the same way, you can see the weighing balance. Here the weighing balance, here the fixed point is in between, that means this acts as a fulcrum. This acts as the effort and this one acts as the load. So the fulcrum is placed between load and the effort, and that is why it is also considered as class 1 levers or first class lever. Even the clippers, which are used while hanging clothes. When we hang clothes, we use clippers, and we use clippers to tighten the clothes so that the clothes do not fly away because of the wind. So here clippers also, in clippers, fulcrum is in between the load and the effort, and that is why it acts as a first class lever, right? Even the plier. In plier also, this acts as the fulcrum. This is the fixed point in between the effort. Here it will be the effort and here will be the load. So this acts as a first class lever or class 1 lever. Even the corkscrew bottle opener, in this fulcrum is in between the load and the effort. This is a very ancient antique type of bottle opener. Nowadays we have modern bottle openers. But this is the old one in which the bottle is placed over here and effort, that means force, is applied over here. This is the fulcrum which is in between and the load is applied over here, through which, that means the corkscrew applies the load through which the bottles open, right? So this also act as a first class lever. Even the hand pump acts as the class 1 lever or first class lever, because in between is the fulcrum, here is the effort. A person actually pulls down this thing and the water comes out from here. So this acts as a load, right? So this is also the class 1 or first class lever, right? Even the crowbar, that also acts as the class 1 lever. And here you can see that a hammer is used to pull the nails. So what is happening here? There is fulcrum, right? Here is the load and here is the effort. So this acts as class 1 lever. So that was all about first class lever or class 1 lever. And now we are going to study about the second class lever. So what is it, children? Yes. Levers in which the load is located between the fulcrum and the effort are called second class or class 2 levers, right? Now what happens? That load is placed in between the fulcrum and the effort. So this will act as the second class lever. So let us discuss about these examples. Yes, this is a wheelbarrow in which at the end there is a fixed point. So this acts as a fulcrum. Then here this acts as a load and the effort, that means force, is applied over here. So this is the second class lever, because load is in between the fulcrum and effort. Second is the nutcracker. Now what happens in the nutcracker? That nut is placed in between. Fulcrum is at the end. So fulcrum is here. Effort is applied over here. And in between is the load. That means a nut is placed in between. So we can say that when load is placed between the effort and the fulcrum, that means it acts as a class 2 lever or second class lever, right? Even the dumpers, here at the end is the fulcrum, here is the load, and here is the effort. So it acts as class 2 levers, right? Even some beans, that is dust beans. So this is a modern type of dustbin, right? In which some parts are being carried out. So what happens? That here at this end, this is a fixed point which acts as the fulcrum, right? And which acts as an effort? This point acts as an effort. And in between, it acts as the load. So we can say that load is in between the fulcrum, this is fulcrum, this is the load, and this is the effort. So load is placed between the fulcrum and effort, and that is why it is considered to be in class 2 levers. The other examples of class 2 levers are the paper cutting. A paper cutting machine, here load is in between the effort and the fulcrum, and that is why it acts as class 2 lever. Even the microwave oven, in between the load is acting and fulcrum is here at the end of the door. So the door of the microwave oven acts as the class 2 lever, not the whole microwave oven, because it is a type of complex machine then. So here we are discussing about a simple machine. So the door of this microwave oven, in which fulcrum is at the end, effort is also at the end, and load is in between. So when load is placed in between the fulcrum and the effort, that acts as the class 2 lever, right? Here also you can see that this is the bottle opener, right? So here is the load, here is the effort, and this, which the pointed end, is the fulcrum, right? So load is acting between the fulcrum and effort, and that is why it is considered to be in second class lever. Always remember, children, that bottle openers come in various shapes and various sizes, in various patterns, in various forms. So every bottle opener is not a class 1 lever or class 2 lever or class 3 lever. It depends upon the shape. It depends upon its pattern that decides that this is the class 1, class 2 or class 3 lever. So such type of bottle opener or can opener is considered as second class lever. Even the water sprayer or the chemical sprayer, here the load acts in between the fulcrum and the effort, and that is why it is considered to be the class 2 levers. Even you can see here, this is OTG, right? This OTG also, the door of this OTG also acts as the class 2 levers. That means load is placed between fulcrum and effort, and that is why this is considered to be class 2 lever. Even the fire extinguisher acts as the class 2 lever, because the load is in between the fulcrum and effort. So this arrow which you can see, the force is applied over here, which acts as an effort. The load is in between and the fulcrum is at the end. So basically we can say that load is in between the fulcrum and the effort, and that is why it is considered, the fire extinguisher is considered to be in class 2 levers. So that was all about second class lever, and now we are going to learn about the third class lever. So what are the third class levers? Yes, levers in which the effort is located between the fulcrum and the load are called the third class or class 3 levers, right? So always remember that when effort is in between, we need concern that where is load and where is fulcrum. But when the effort is placed in between the fulcrum and the load, that means it is considered to be in the third class lever, or we can call it as class 3 levers. So what are the examples of class 3 levers? Yes, the first example is that of a fishing rod, right? A fishing rod is used to catch the fish out of water or from the water. So here what happens, that effort is actually in between. This fish is a load, and the person which is handling or holding a fishing rod acts as the fulcrum. So this end point, the fixed point, acts as the fulcrum. In between is the load, and here is, in between it is the effort, and here is the load. So basically the effort is in between the fulcrum and load, and that is why a fishing rod is considered to be in class 3 levers, right? Even a person who is holding a shovel, if he is holding a shovel, then imagine that this is a person's hand. So a person's hand here will act as the fulcrum. Here is the load, and in between is the effort. So effort, when effort is in between the fulcrum and the load, that means a shovel is also acting as, the third class lever or class 3 levers. Even the stepler acts as the class 3 levers, because effort is in between the fulcrum and load. Here W means work. Work done. That means if force is applied, that means it is the load on which work is to be performed, and that is why we can consider it as load also or work also, right? Even the traffic barrier, this traffic barrier is also acting as class 3 lever, because here at the end is the fulcrum. This is the rod which opens from here. So this acts as the load, and effort is in between. So when effort is placed between the fulcrum and the load, that means it acts as the class 3 lever. Even the towing machine, here in the towing machine, a car acts as a load. Here is the effort, and here there is fulcrum. So load, this is the load, right? So effort is placed between the load and the fulcrum, and that is why a towing machine is considered to be in class 3 levers. Let us discuss more examples about this class of lever. Yes, a pair of tongs. A pair of tongs are used by the person to hold on something, right? Like we can see here. So if a person holds a pair of tongs, then here at the end it will act as the load. Here will be the effort, and the person who is holding its elbow will act as the fulcrum. So we can say that effort is between the fulcrum and load, and that is why it is considered to be in class 3 levers. Even the brooms, which are held, which is held by a woman or any other man which holds this broom, here her elbow will act as the fulcrum, or the shoulder will act as the fulcrum, the rod will act as an effort, and this is acted as load. So effort is placed between the fulcrum and load, and that is why it is considered to be in class 3 levers. Even a hammer, which is held by a person. A person is holding a hammer, and here effort is being made. Here is the load, and here at the end it is the fulcrum. So effort is in between the fulcrum and the load, and that is why it is considered to be in third class lever. Even the swing, a sweet girl is swinging. Here this chain, a rod, is acting as an effort. A girl which is sitting on this bar is acting as a load, and this, the swing which is holded on to a rod, is acting as a fulcrum. So effort is in between fulcrum and load, and that is why it is considered to be in class 3 levers. Even if a person or a farmer, when plowing the field or plowing into the soil or giving some nutrients to the soil or adding manure or compost to the soil, here the rod will act as an effort. This end will act as the load, and fulcrum will act at the end. So this is considered to be in class 3 levers, right? Even in the frying pan with a pair of tongs, this acts as effort. The hand with which the pair of tongs are held acts as a fulcrum, and here it acts as a load. Even the dustbin, here the upper part of the dustbin which covers the dustbin, that acts as an effort. So effort is actually placed between the fulcrum and the load, and that is why it is considered to be in class 3 levers. Even when a boy is hammering on this machine, on this thing, what happens? That this is acting as the fulcrum, this acts as the effort, and this acts as a load. So we can say that basically effort is in between the fulcrum and the load, and that is why it is considered to be in class 3 levers. The same thing is here, that the effort is in between, here is the load, effort is in between, and this is the fulcrum. So effort is in between the fulcrum and the load. Even a girl which is hammering on the boxes. So what acts as a fulcrum? Yes, this end, her elbow, acts as a fulcrum. This acts as an effort, and this box on which the effort or the force is applied acts as the load. So effort is in between load and fulcrum, and that is why it is considered to be in class 3 levers. Right? So we discussed many examples of first, second and third class levers. Always remember that the fulcrum, when it is placed in between effort and load, it is the first class lever. When load is in between the fulcrum and the effort, it is the second class lever. And when effort is in between the fulcrum and the load, that means it is the third class lever. So always remember the trick. Whatever is present in between, that is basically important to classify these levers. So always remember FLE, right? When fulcrum is in between first class lever, load is in between second class lever, and E is in between, then when E is in the middle, then that means effort is in middle, then third class lever, right? So I hope you enjoyed this session and learned about the simple machine, one such simple machine known as lever. We will discuss about other simple machines in the next session. Till then, keep learning, keep enjoying.